You know, sometimes some review don't make sense. And I'm not sure this one will. Let me explain. 9 short months ago, Intel released its KB-like lineup of processor and the Z370 powered motherboard, which will support it. 9 short months ago. And now, Intel has just released its 8th generation of iProcessor, the Coffee Lake. And of course, with it comes a Z370 chipset powered motherboard. Wow, what a year. Point is, today I have the early release of a Prime Z370-A motherboard from Asus. And what kind of new features did they come up in just 9 months? I mean, what does the Z370 chipset brings on top of the very young and already very well-featured Z270 chipset? Well, we're about to find out, so let's roll that intro. Alright, so I'm not gonna repeat myself. The Z270 is being pushed out of the market after 9 short months of existence, and it is now being replaced, or Intel is trying to replace it with its new Z370 chipset. But why such a rush, you may ask? Two words: AMD, Ryzen. In short, when Ryzen's lineup processor was released, there was nothing on Intel's side to oppose it. Ever since, AMD has been eating away small parts of the mainstream CPU market to the detriment of Intel. Alright, so I'll be talking about CPUs and processors in a short while in an incoming video, so stay tuned for that. But today we are here about motherboards. So let's first take a quick look at the chipset. Z270 versus Z370. Simply said, there's really not much of differences. They're practically the very same chipset with a couple of tweaks and bandwidth upgrades. For example, on the Z270 chipset, we have 24 second generation PCIe lanes, and on the Z370 chipset, we have 24 of third generation PCIe lanes. And for gamers like me, it's always good news. Also, on the Z270 chipset, we have 10 third generation USB, which can deliver up to 5 gigabit per second, which has been upgraded on the Z370 platform to 3.1. Now that 0.1 is interesting and important because it doubles as well our transfer output to 10 gigabit per second. Whee! And finally, the last noticeable, and I would call that marginal, difference is on the RAID. On one side, we didn't have PCIe Express RAID supported. On the Z370, it does support it at 0.1 and I think mode 5. And I'm not sure that's very important. That's why I call it marginal, because I really don't see budget builders or, you know, first-time builders using that thing. Sounds pretty advanced. But hey, it's here. I'm not gonna complain about this. So you get the point. At the very end of the day, the Z270 really is a Z370, and the Z370 is just a marginally upgraded Z270 chipset. So why would you go there? Well, simply because the Z370 chipset is the only chipset which will support the new Coffee Lake processor. Alright, so now that we have a little bit of context, it is time to take a closer look to our Prime Z370... Prime Z370-A. That is why we're here, after all. So, when Asus release a motherboard which starts with Prime, that usually means that this is an entry level for that chipset category. Makes sense. So this is a motherboard which will try to marry budget and all the new features that this chipset brings to the game, brings to the table. And because the Z270 and Z370 are so similar, we have very similar motherboards from the previous generation. But as usual, nothing will better illustrate my point than the unboxing. So, unboxing. Alright, so here's our box. So I'm gonna put the motherboard aside for now. And here we have our M.2 solid state drive screw and screw riser, a couple of SATA cables, a padded IO shield, a two-way SLI bridge, a CPU installer, a fan mount kit. Okay, so that's a new one, and we will see what that does when I'll be installing this motherboard into a build. A cable coupon, our front panel connector bridge, a quick start guide, and finally our DVD driver and manual. Alright, so let's go back to our motherboard. Obviously, this is an ATX motherboard, so perfect for smaller and middle builds. And let's start with the obvious. the socket. Our LGA 1151 socket, as you can see, this is the very same socket that we've seen in previous Skylake microarchitecture. Now, because this is a Z370 powered motherboard, this LGA 1151 socket is not compatible with Kaby Lake and Skylake processors. It will fit in there perfectly, but as you attempt to start the system for the very first time, it will simply not boost. The only processor you can run on this is the new Coffee Lake processor. And it goes the same way around. You cannot use a Coffee Lake processor on Z270 or Z170 powered motherboard. So let's make this clear once and for all. Memory wise, we have the classic dual channel configuration that the Z chipset have accustomed us with. You can run up to 64 gigabytes of DDR4 RAM and overclock them up to 4,000 megahertz. Remaining in the memory compartment, our Prime Z370-A can accommodate up to 2 M.2 solid state drive in an horizontal position. And as we've already seen with its predecessor, the Z370 chipset is Opten ready, meaning that both our M.2 solid state drive sticks can transfer data up to 32 gigabit per second in theory and individually. Now, that translates in very, very hot M.2 solid state drive sticks. And that is why on the other side of our chipset shield, we will find a thermopad. And if that's not enough, we also have a 3D mount right here for the very same M.2 solid state drive, which we can use to install a 60mm fan. All right, PCIe wise, we have no less than 7 third generation PCIe Express slots. 4 of them are single slot, single speed. 3 of them are 16 slots, but do have different kind of speeds. The very first PCIe Express, the closest one to the CPU, is the only one which can run up to 16 full bus speed. And that means that if you are going with a single VGA card, you will want it to be placed right here for optimal performances. If you are going to go for multiple video card configurations, say a two-way SLI or Crossfire, you will place them on the two first PCI slots, the metallically reinforced ones, and they will be sharing the bus bandwidth, delivering individually up to 8 bus speed. The last 16 slot PCI Express is capped up to 4 bus speed and is also sharing its bandwidth with the previous 2 PCI slots, meaning that if we're using the 3 of them, we will be finding ourselves in an 8 plus 4 plus 4 bus speed configuration. So if we are going to go for this kind of motherboard and processor, I would not recommend more than one GPU configuration. It doesn't make sense. You'd be spending a lot of money on your video card and still be capped by the shared bandwidth, the 8 bus speed or the 4 plus 4. Doesn't make sense. All right, peripheral wise. First, on our I/O panel, we have, starting from the left, a 3.1 second generation Type A and Type C USB, 3 different video output, a DVI, an HDMI, and a DisplayPort. Then we have 2 second generation USB plugs, a gigabit LAN inlet, a couple of 3.1 first generation USB plugs, and finally our different audio channels, 5 analog and 1 optical. SATA wise, we have 6 3.0 plugs which can all transfer individually up to 6 gigabit per second. As onboard peripherals goes, we have 2 USB second generation connectors and 2 USB 3.1 first generation connectors. Alright, so we've just reviewed the general aspect and features of our board, but there are a couple of things here which is more on the premium side and, frankly talking, made me very happy to see. First things first, we have a couple of buttons, the power switch and memory OK check buttons, which are directly soldered onto the motherboard. Again, that's something that enthusiasts will appreciate and which makes our lives a little bit easier when testing our very first boot. And on top of our different fan connectors, we have right here an all-in-one pump PWM, and that's pretty cool because it also gives us the possibility to operate a custom water cooling loop in a minimal configuration. And talking about water cooling, we also have a thermal sensor right there. For the ones who know my videos, you may already know what's coming next. The Aura Sync effect. If you do not know what that is, you have homework. Oh, that was a good one. That one sounded really cool. Well, in a nutshell, the Aura Sync effect is an Asus proprietary software which will sync all the different Aura compatible LG RGB LED on the different components of your build so that they can all glow in an harmonious way or have really cool looking effect, etc., etc., etc. So that is very important for the enthusiast to really give attention to what their build will look like, such as me. And in the Prime Z370-A, they are not hidden under the chipset shield or the I/O housing, no. This time, Asus has hidden 8 small RGB LED right at the fringe of our motherboard. And I really like this because it's a more subtle way to light and decorate your casing instead of just blinking in your face. It gives that little colorful shadow on the floor of your case. So double kudos for this. And that is not all. If you want to add a RGB export such as an RGB Aura compliant cable, then you can do it right here. Really cool, indeed, really cool. In conclusion, well, it is a very well-rounded entry-level motherboard, that's for sure. Best part of it all, the price. This board, the street price of this board is about $175. $175, below the $200 mark, well below the $200 mark. And that means that we can put more money on the processor. So if you are going for, say, a sub $1,000 build, you have plenty of budget room to add yourself an i5, possibly an i7, a bunch of RAM, an all-in-one cooler, a very decent video card. So, you know what? I would definitely start with this board for a new Coffee Lake build. I would not go for anything else, especially if you're on a budget. But I really hope for that the next Z series generation, the Prime motherboards will, you know, let the SATA plugs go away for the benefit of something more useful, such as a QLED screen, because when you have the ability to put 2 or 3 M.2 solid state drive, why do we bother with SATA plugs? The Prime Z370-A will simply give you all the different features that the Coffee Lake has to offer. Anything on top of this, Strix or Maximus, is luxury and enthusiastic driven. It is not necessary. If you want necessity, this is where you want to go. And I'd go on this quick because they usually go very, very fast. That's it. You have it.